hopefully you've been following my blog a little bit. It's pretty short-lived. If you haven't, please do. Please come check it out. You're here. Hopefully this has something to do with that. I'm taking a chance today. I've been writing, and I thought I would add some practical, like talk you through it. I'm not following the script. I don't even have the blog in front of me. I'd be smart to have it up on a computer or something. I could check the outline, and maybe another time I will. But this is my number one first time doing this, so I'm talking to you because I want to get to know you, and I want you to get to know me. My name is Willy Kelly. I've been a musician since I was a teenager. I've been gigging since I was a teenager. I've been playing music all my adult life, and I have a master's degree in music education. I've worked as a music teacher in public schools and colleges, and done numerous albums. I've worked with many people, helping them to record and produce albums in Maine, you know. Back in my youth, I toured and got to see the United States and Canada, and I've played and played and played. And I'm not the best musician I know, but I have a lot of fun. And I'm here to try to help educate if I can, and to entertain you if I can, and to certainly encourage you if I can to play and listen and enjoy music. I live on the beautiful coast of Maine. I can go outside with the dogs and have them lost right at the ocean in about 2 minutes. Hopefully that won't happen. And they seem to like music, okay, so we're getting in the right track. And please check out my post that you'll find this into. Today, I wanted to share with you drop D tuning. Drop D is just the low E string is tuned down to a D, a whole step down. I like this tuning because the wicked has got that deeper low end. It's got lots of opportunities for that's where I started with drop D back, way back, whenever. I may have a song up with that style of playing, and I'm not sure if I do. If I don't, I'll put one up. So, I also have learned to really love lots of get that low drone, but lots of jangly chords and notes and things ringing all over. I have the words just in case, and if I forget, then I forget. In a moment, I'm going to play through the song. I'm just recording this straight ahead on a phone. Usually I like to do a recording in my music room. If I get a chance, I will. But the truth is, with the dogs here and stuff right now, everybody's quiet. I thought I'd give this a try and see if I can get a sound that'll work for us. Okay? I'll just show you. The introduction. Well, you can see I'm hitting D, 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 and the melody's on the fifth string. Piece cake, right? One note up, I love that dissonance. And then there's a D with an F sharp in the bottom. Move one note up, G. Move it back down, F sharp minor, E minor, 7, D. Also, notice one thing with drop D, you gotta cover the bottom string. See that? Because if I play a regular E, it's an E7, which actually isn't terrible if you want a rumbling 7 in the bottom, which you may want at some point. But when I'm in this song, I don't want that. I want this. So I cover both notes. I think on the... Here's something if you watch the video. I think in the blog, I put it so that three fingers cover in those notes and then the first finger here is usually. But what I really do is I play like an E, and then with this middle finger, I just cover both strings. That's a little something I like to do when I can. There's a B minor that I like. And I won't play the high E string until I want to. And it becomes a suspension. Sometimes I'm muting. I'm just kind of loosely covering that. You get the note rolling down, and then there you are. So, the song is by a group called Left Bank. Was Baroque and Roll, I saw one reference to it called. And that was because of some of the background and some of the instrumentation and the way they played it. Kind of a misnomer. I may do a post on that one day soon. I started one actually a while back, and I don't know, it just got deep and it came time to put one out. And so I'm trying to be consistent. That's one of the things we need to do, right? I want you to feel like you can come back every week and find me and find something new, hopefully enjoyable or educational. And like I say, I would encourage you to play. I'll probably say that again before I get done, just because I appreciate encouragement. I hope you do too. So, it's early morning. First song of the day. The Left Bank, it's called Walk Away Renee. I know it's been covered a lot, and I just like the tune. I just have always liked the tune, and so I opted to cover it myself. And here we go. And when I see the sign points one walk away, Renee, you won't see me follow you back home. The empty sidewalks on my block are not the same. You're not to blame. From deep inside the tears, I'm forced to cry. From deep inside the pain, I choose to hide. Just walk away, Renee. You won't see me follow you back home. Now as the rain beats down upon one little part, that walk down in the minor chord is just like, that's an old, it's a cliche, but again, you know, it works. It's a cliche and it works. That's why it's a cliche. So I would say, I hope this helps. Check out the blog. All the fingerings are there. I wrote in music. I'm a fan of music written out, even if you use fingerings written on or which string you're playing on, which is, I studied classical guitar a long time ago, and I won't even attempt to go there for now, but as opposed to tab, I'm not a big fan of tab. I guess if you know, you can see the frets. I get why people like it. I totally get that. I've just always struggled with that. To me, it's a little easier to read the notes and think about the fingerings. Guitar players have a lot of opportunity to choose fingerings the way they want to. B minor chord. B minor chord. B minor chord. Funky B minor chord. So, you know what I mean? If it says B minor, I'm like, I'll play anywhere I want. You know, that's kind of one of the things with playing guitar that's nice. So again, I encourage you to play. I encourage you to have fun with this. I encourage you to write me. Please subscribe, write me, let me know what you want to know about. I've taught a lot of music, and I'm going to probably present a lot of things here. So I'm bare infancy of this, so I'm growing along with you. So I hope that works out for both of us. And the dogs are just about asleep. Maybe I'll just go get a cup of tea and chill for a little while. Thank you. Thank you for being here. See you hopefully next time around. As they used to say, see you in the funny papers. Mm-hmm.